At last the people in a body to the town hall came flocking. 'Tis clear, cried they, our mayors are noddy, and as for our corporations, shocking to think we buy gowns lined with ermine for dolts that can't or won't determine what's best to rid us of our vermin. The mayor and councillors felt insane. It's easy to bid me rack my brain. I'm sure my poor head aches again. I've scratched it so, and all in vain. Oh, for a trap, a trap, a trap. Just as he said this, what should hap at the chamber door but a gentle tap? Bless us, cried the mayor, what's that? Only a scraping of shoes on the mat. Anything like the sound of a rat makes my heart go pitter-pat. Come in, the mayor cried, looking bigger, and in did come the strangest figure. His queer long coat from heel to head was half of yellow and half of red. He himself was tall and thin, with sharp blue eyes, each like a pin, and light blue hair, yet swarthy skin, no tuft on cheek nor beard on chin, but lips where smiles went out and in. He advanced to the council table, and, please your honour, said he, I'm able by means of a secret charm to draw all creatures living beneath the sun that creep or swim or fly or run after me so as you never saw. And I chiefly use my charm on creatures that do people harm, the mole and toad and newt and viper, and people call me the Pied Piper. And here they noticed round his neck a scarf of red and yellow stripe to match with his coat of the selfsame check, and at the scarf's end hung a pipe, and his fingers they noticed were ever straying, as if impatient to be plain. If I can rid your town of rats, will you give me 1,000 guilders? 150,000 was the exclamation of the astonished mayor and corporation.